welcome to this special edition of the Young Filmmakers Project. I'm Nick Fool. Tonight we're at the historic Kiggins Theater in downtown Vancouver for the first ever Young Adult Northwest Film Festival. The film festival brings together middle and high schoolers from across Vancouver to show off their work. The films will be scored by a group of judges, and at the end of the night, we'll have winners in a variety of categories. The festival was organized by two local teenagers. And joining me now are the organizers. I've got Halima Tufts, a junior at Vancouver School of Arts and Academics, Danny Garrison, a freshman at Heritage High School. Guys, this is really cool. Why did you guys decide to organize a film festival?
I think it's really important to have young filmmakers and be able to showcase their work to the community. And I really wanted to bring together the historic Kiggins Theater, which is a beautiful piece of architecture, and also the community. So, yeah.
Danny, how about you?
I think it's really fun to have a film and make a film with friends. Even if not friends, you can always acting as a way to just not be yourself and be someone else and have fun with it. It's always just a great time just to make a film with other people. So
you guys are obviously high schoolers. This is a huge project. Like, professionals do this sort of thing. What was the process of putting all this together? I mean, who wants to go here? Okay.
Yeah. It was about a 8-month process for me. I started this project at the beginning of the school year, and so it is a lot of work trying to get the funds for it, trying to rally everyone together. It was a lot of work, but it's really paid off, and I'm really proud of how it's turned out.
What do you have to say?
My dad was really a big hand in this. I started about 8th grade with the idea and then branched out during freshman year of high school. So really it's been a 2-year process, and my dad just kind of branching out to other people to get the word out. So
you guys had started independent film festivals. You learned of each other's existence, and you decided to team up. Why'd you guys decide to do that?
I just think the bigger the better. More submissions, more fun for people to join, and more people to meet.
I will assume along the same lines for you as well. You guys like to make movies yourselves, right? That's why you're doing this sort of thing. Why is it important for you guys to have an outlet like filmmaking in your lives as high school students?
I think it's really important to have a creative outlet. It can really benefit you in multiple ways, whether that be trying to deal with stress or anything like that. And I think that being able to put your vision out there for other people to see is really cool and like a great experience.
And how long have you been making movies?
About 3 years now.
Just one day you decided I'm going to try picking up a camera and see what happens.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, I started when I was little, kind of doing like short fun videos with my friends and stuff, but I really got serious about 3 years ago.
How about you, Danny? You've been making movies for a while?
Yeah, I think ever since like the first grade. I've been in multiple films, George Fox, all those sorts of places, and then over time I've been making films with friends, and just the more friends there are like on set, it's just so much more fun. It's like a family.
And why do you think it's important for yourself to have this sort of creative outlet?
Because sometimes like you're in school, it's just so boring. It's just looking forward to the film and looking forward to creating the film and seeing the film. It's just such a great process. Always happy.
So people at home have not yet seen any of the movies we're going to see tonight. Were you surprised by the kind of response you got, the entries you got? Are we going to see some cool stuff tonight?
I really think so. So many submissions. We did not expect this many. It took a long time to filter out this to get enough for people to see, like sit here for 2 hours, and it was just so great. And I'm so excited for people to see these films.
And Halima, were you surprised as well?
Yeah, I really love these films. I think the kids did a really good job, put a lot of hard work into it. So it's gonna be exciting to see people's reactions.
Okay, so first ever, is this gonna be an annual event? What do you see the future of this film festival kind of being?
Yeah, I would love for this to be annual. I'd love to keep doing it. It's really fun, very like a fulfilling thing to do. So I'd love to keep going with it.
Kind of along the same lines, I'm guessing.
Yeah, I mean, like making it bigger and better every year, just building a stronger filmmaking base.
Well, that's great. Thank you, guys. I'm really looking forward to seeing the films tonight, and good job on organizing all this. As I mentioned, tonight's festival is here at the historic Kiggins Theater. Kiggins opened way back in 1936. The first film shown, a romantic comedy called She Married Her Boss, starring Claudette Colbert and Melvin Douglas. The theater has gone through a lot of up and downs over the decades, but it remains a great place to see a film right here in Vancouver. And joining me now is the owner of the theater, Dan Wyatt. Dan, thanks for joining us here.
Oh, absolutely. Looking forward to it.
So why is a festival like this something that Kiggins wanted to be a part of?
Well, I was a student filmmaker once myself, so I have a soft spot in my heart for kids making movies, and they are the next generation of filmmakers, so the sooner we can start them learning the story craft, telling with visual images, the better.
And you sort of brought up when you're talking about young filmmakers like yourself when you were a kid. How is Kiggins connected to the community? Because this is such a community-oriented event.
Yeah, this place has been here for generations. I came here as a kid, came and watched movies, and I like to see that continue, whether it's locally produced art or big-budget studio films. Kiggins is just a community gathering space. I mean, movies are better enjoyed together in a group setting rather than isolated in your home or with your small screen. So it's important that we get together and watch movies from the amateur level all the way up to professional.
Yeah, and kind of exciting to think that maybe somebody you see here tonight, you know, in a few years, maybe they have a professional film here.
Yeah, you know, Hollywood's a funny place. No name from today is a big star tomorrow.
And you sort of touched on this, but what do you think it is about film in general that brings people together? I mean, everybody loves movies, right?
Well, you would hope so. Yeah, I think, film is a collaborative art. I mean, it takes a group of people to make a movie. It's really kind of miraculous when one comes together so well, but it's unlike a painting or a book. You can't just have a singular author or an artist, if you will. It takes a whole group of people collaborating, hopefully under one vision of the director, and making a movie that is then joined by a community. So it's communal from start to finish.
And so what do you think the kids are getting out of this? Kids who go to the trouble, they do all this collaboration, they make these movies. What are they getting out of this besides just like a cool film?
Well, Robert Rodriguez is famously said, everybody's got about 20 or so bad movies in them. So it's important just to get those movies made, get them out of your system, practice your craft, study the art, and improve as a filmmaker and a storyteller.
So I assume you enjoy then working with kids like this when they come in. It's got to see a little bit of yourself in there.
Oh, absolutely. And I've always hoped that there would be more in Vancouver. I'm excited to finally be hosting a student film festival here. We did one about a month ago that wasn't so much a focus on the art. It was more about a subject in a documentary format. But I'm excited to see a lot of narrative films here and a lot of films from different genres and just different unique perspectives on storytelling. Been desiring this before I even acquired the theater, so I'm glad to see it finally happen.
Well, it's okay. We finally have this movie film festival here. Where do you think the future of this is going to be here at Kiggins?
There's always a home for it here, as long as there's a student ready to spearhead it, because I myself and others have tried to reach out to the community and the schools. These things are best done when there's student ownership and student involvement. So it takes somebody like Halima stepping up and Danny from Heritage to put these things together. So I know they got a few years under their belt left in high school, so hopefully they continue during their academic career, but perhaps they can hand it off and train up the next generation to keep this going to where it's decades long.
Well, that's great. Well, thanks for hosting this tonight. I can't wait to see the films, and thanks for joining me.
Oh, yeah, absolutely. Thanks for having us.
Let's listen in as the organizers greet the audience, and then we'll watch some movies.
All of these films are incredible, and you guys should be incredibly proud. Good luck to all of you, and enjoy the show.
Good evening. Welcome to Dateline Murder Mystery. Tonight's topic, murder. 22-year-old victim Freddie Frederick was murdered in cold blood at a restaurant in 2014. Why would anyone harm Freddie? Who was his killer? Was his killer ever caught? Why am I asking you these questions you don't know the answers to? Find out tonight on Dateline. Now you may be wondering what happened to young Freddie and how he was murdered. Luckily for you, that's what our show's about. We have classified video surveillance of what happened that night. Freddie Frederick showed up to Vinny's Pizza at 7:32 p.m. However, when he walked in, he remembered something. He didn't like pizza. So why'd Freddie come to your establishment if he didn't like pizza?
Yeah, Freddie was kind of a weird guy. He'd come in a couple days a week and then just announce out loud, "Oh yeah,
I hate pizza.
And then he'd eat something like a cookie or a steamed ham and then just walk out.
So what was it that led up to his murder that night?
Well, Freddie walked in just like any other normal night. I expected him to just say his normal thing.
"Oh yeah, I hate pizza."
Then he'd eat something that wasn't my pizza and then he'd walk out, you know? But it didn't happen like that.
What did happen?
It was that banana. I don't know what happened. Maybe he's never eaten a banana or something, but it killed him. I just don't know why he did it.
Why he ate the banana?
Why'd the banana kill him?
That's a question I thought to myself. Why would banana kill Freddy? Banana grew up in a stable household as an only child, with parents who loved him dearly. But all that changed when he left the bunch and got hooked on a life of crime.
Mr. Banana has always been a loose cannon, and he's fired before. For example, he was our prime suspect for the Main Street bank robbery a couple months back. He took $2.5 million, and along with it, two people's lives.
But is this bruised banana guilty? The case just seemed about closed until new security footage surfaced occurring on the same night of the murder. Commissioner, are you aware that new security footage has been found that brings new light to the investigation?
No. I haven't heard about that.
Stop, lawyer!
That's not me.
Well, wouldn't that also explain the bullet holes in Mr. Frederick?
It was an accident?
Well, another day, another culprit, another murder. The commissioner tried to frame an innocent banana for the crime, but he was the one who ended up getting peeled. Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe. I'm a generic host, and thanks for watching.
Does it really matter? Yeah, I know. Yeah, my doctor said to, schedule an appointment.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay, Friday at 10? Mm-hmm. Yeah, I'll shoot. Okay, all right. Yeah, I've been taking the pills for about a week now. It's kind of helping, honestly, but I don't know. Mm-hmm. Okay. Bye-bye. Okay, Friday at 10 a.m., 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 Friday at 10 a.m. Okay, all right, Friday at 10 a.m., Friday at 10 a.m. Hey, Eli, can you turn off the light? I'm going to go to sleep. So, I need to pay for my medical bills. Now, let's start robbing houses again.
Yeah, we should. I need
one
else.
Yeah. So yeah, I was looking at a few houses, and there's one on 17th Street that's really nice. It's like a big house, and I think they got a lot of cool stuff in there. I'm gonna let you do the work, obviously, and I'm gonna go and scout out the house right now. You down? Yeah.
Yeah, I'm down.
Hello.
Yeah, bro, what's up? Where's the stuff? I'm at the hiding place. There's nothing here.
Zarko just stumbled across it.
You did rob the place, right?
Bro, I robbed the place. I got a lot of stuff and I left it all over there.
I don't know, man. We probably just need to find a better hiding spot or something.
Dude, it's whatever. See you later.
Dude, Oliver, you're repeating the details of the heist in your sleep, including the hiding place. Thank you.
Okay, give me all your money. Give me all your money. Hey, what are you doing? I said, give it to me. Man, are you okay? I'm not gonna rob a depressed guy. Do you wanna, like, talk about it or something? I was in a pretty bad place once too, you know? Yeah, you wanna know what got me out of it?
What?
Petty crime.
There's just one more stop we need to make.
Okay, I'm done. This place? Come on, what are we gonna do, steal food?
No, there's something I need to do.
Wait, what? Hold on.
Just stay in the car, okay?
Where have you been? You missed your shift.
Hectic day.
Really? Are you gonna tell me the true story or am I gonna have to fire you?
Just what I needed to do.
What did you... Oh my god, are those for us? What did you do?
It's not that big a deal.
Oh god, Jesus. Alexa, what day is it?
It's Saturday, April 14th.
Alexa, sing happy birthday to me.
Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday, happy birthday. Happy birthday to you.
Alexa, what's the weather today?
Right now in Vancouver, it's 53 degrees Fahrenheit with cloudy skies.
Alexa, what is mascara made out of?
Mascara's materials are castor oil, turpentine, paraffin wax, carbon black, methyl cellulose, tragacanth, and cerisin.
Alexa, am I pretty?
Nothing looks better than confidence.
Alexa, have a good day.
Thanks. You too.
You all had a great weekend. We have a little surprise for you this morning, a little pop quiz. So if you can please put out all your devices, put them away, and go ahead and get out a pen or pencil. We'll begin. Seriously? You know no phone's on an exam.
Alexa, remind me to call the dog walker.
When should I remind you?
In an hour. Alexa, am I free tomorrow?
But Wally has just arrived on Netflix.
Alexa, what are my notifications?
One message from Mom, sorry we can't make it home. We put money in your account if you want to have a party.
Alexa, order some balloons.
Balloons have been ordered.
Alexa, order me a cake.
Cake ordered.
Alexa, order flowers.
Flowers are ordered.
Alexa, invite my friends to my party.
Sorry, I can't find your friends.
I wish I had friends.
I'm always your friend. I'm always here.
Thank you.
have recently come to the conclusion that I am God. I have inhuman abilities that prove this to me. 2 days ago, I woke up surrounded by dirt. I didn't know where I was, I didn't know my own first name, who I was, or how I got there. I wasn't sure where I was going, but a sixth sense pulled me toward the road. I followed it for what seemed like minutes until I happened upon a strange structure. It seemed familiar, though I was sure I'd never seen such a thing before. I get these images. They flash in and out of my subconscious, alluding to my powers. It really did look familiar, especially from the inside. I continued wandering around until I happened upon my reflection. I wished for water, and it came. It was then I realized I possessed the power of creation. I was unsure of why, but I knew that my powers were keeping this box cold. I used my power to heat it. It was incredible.
Hey babe, how was your hike? Something happened? Who are you? I have so much to show you.
Maya, I don't think you're ready for this, but you...
What? A light switch?
No. Watch.
Yeah? What about it? You're just turning the lights on and off.
Yeah. With my mind.
No.
No, yeah.
No.
Look. Listen, I can prove it to you. Okay.
What are you doing?
I know that it's kind of hard to take this all in, but I... Yeah, I think I...
Lyric, did something happen to you?
No.
On your hike? Did you fall, hit your head?
I mean...
What happened to you on your hike? Did you hit your head, like... I'm really concerned. You're acting ridiculous.
I'm fine.
No, you just flicked a light switch on and off and told me it was magic.
It was magic.
It's not.
Yes, it is.
You need to go to the hospital or something. You need to get checked out.
Next thing you know, you're gonna be telling me this isn't magic.
Thank you.
Where's the milk? What? You're me! Am I really that ugly?
Well, I thought we looked pretty cute. Well, this is the part where you're supposed to run.
Oh, okay. Oh, no!
Whole life because of you, and I'm sick of it.
What?
You know what? Forget it. You're useless.
It's been 14 years living in the shadows. Allison this and Allison that. But no one cares about Alessandra. It's my time to shine!
Oh no, where'd you go?
Allison, where are you?
She keeps running away.
Gina, you won't believe what just happened. There's two of me. She's trying to kill me. I'm gonna die. She's crazy.
Okay, I'll ask a question that only the true Allison would know.
It's me!
What is my favorite Taylor Swift song?
I know!
Wildest Dreams.
What? It's the Wildest Dreams remix.
Ding, 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 ding. Correct.
Well, looks like it's time for me to go.
Yeah, get out of here.
That was a really weird dream.
Yeah, that was weird, wasn't it?
You've got to be kidding me.
Hi, welcome to Chili's.
Oh my god, I'm scared.
Walk in.
Oh. Hi, welcome to my party.
Hi, welcome to Chili's. The shark.
Oh, shit.
Stop laughing!
Shut up.
Unhook the thing. I got it. Watch out.
That was cool.
You need me to catch you at the end? Alright, well, my parents are here to pick me up. Bye.
Wake up, citizens. Time to get to work. Wake up, citizens. Wake up, citizens. Wake up, citizens.
Dark in here, you're gonna hurt your eyes.
What do you want? You got 45 seconds.
I wanna leave. I can't live here anymore.
You're kidding, right? You can't be serious.
No, I'm 100% serious. But if it's too dangerous, I'll go.
I can give you 2 hours. That's the best I can do. You'll know when the monitors go off.
I can do it. Yeah.
Wait, just tell me the stories when you get back.
I can do it.
Finally, I can get started.
Wake up, citizens. Time to get to work.
innocent, I swear. I didn't kill that girl.
That is Felicity Heron. She's on trial for murder in the first degree.
Okay, I know this looks bad, but is this all really necessary? She's just a kid. I am wholeheartedly against this. Murder is wrong. Murder is wrong no matter what the person did. It was an accident, and I think she just deserves a second chance.
That's Becca McLean, Felicity's lawyer. She's strongly against the death penalty. I don't blame her. Before we get into that, let's go back. Look at the whole story. We'll see what you think.
Prosecutor, please give your opening statement.
I intend to prove to the jury that this girl is guilty. I call Mavis Lynn to the stage.
Yay!
Now, Mavis, did you or did you not catch the girl stealing from your store?
I did! Liar!
Order in the court.
Thank you very much. I have proven my point. You may sit now. You see? She was caught in the act and for some reason still claims not to have stolen. She needs to be punished. May I call up the evidence, please?
Jury, please bring up the evidence.
Your Honor. See this? We found this in her pocket.
Defendant, now you may give your statement.
My client pleads innocent.
Is this not interesting enough for you?
Honestly, yes. All of this over a chocolate bar?
Murder! Murder!
Does that mean too?
Order! Defendant is now put on trial for murder in the first degree. The punishment will be death by execution. The jury may go and discuss now. According to the Oregonian, in 1995, the trials for three Washington County murder cases cost more than $1.5 million. One was sentenced to death. Also, according to deathpenaltyinfo.org, cases without the death penalty cost $740,000, while cases where the death penalty is sought cost $1.26 million. Maintaining each death row prisoner costs taxpayers $90,000 per year, then more per year than a prisoner in general population.
Okay, guys, do you want to put it to a vote? All who vote guilty, raise your hand. All who oppose.
Why?
We must decide. She's a murderer. She must die. Y'all saw it. Don't deny it.
The death penalty violates the right to live, which is the most basic of all human rights.
She violated juror number 3's right to life.
Well, it also violates the right not to be subjected to torture and other cruel, inhuman, or degrading treatment or punishment.
But it helps keep crime down, right?
Actually, according to Amnesty.org, after Canada dropped the death penalty, it saw that 44% drop in murders across the country, and it wasn't alone.
That doesn't give her the right to be let off the hook, though. You want to put her in jail so the taxpayers can let her sit in a comfy jail cell with a roof overhead for 3 meals a day.
It's a small price to pay for human life, and I think it's worth it.
She killed someone, that's that.
She's a murderer.
A monster.
She's a little girl, but I'm not going to stand in your way if you must kill her. If you truly think she deserves this, then let's put her to another vote.
Okay, all who vote guilty? All who vote innocent? All who vote innocent? Juror 2?
Guilty.
Jury, have you come to a conclusion?
We find the defendant guilty.
Felicity Heron, I hereby sentence you to death. Any last words?
My only regret is that I didn't try every chocolate.
Wait, she's innocent. I got an autopsy report back from the doctor. Juror number 3 died from a heart attack.
I told you not to kill her!
She was innocent.
Okay, according to OADP.org, since the reinstatement of death penalty in the United States in 1976, 138 innocent men and women have been released from death row, including some who came within minutes of execution. In Missouri, Texas, and Virginia, investigations have opened up to determine if those states executed innocent men.
This short film is based on a real case that happened in Texas. Cameron Todd Willingham was executed in Texas 2004 for allegedly setting fire that killed his 3 daughters. further evidence revealed that Willingham did not set the fire. And he was innocent. But it came too late. The death penalty is something you can't take back. Everyone deserves a chance to live. Even if it's them rotting away in jail. The death penalty is wrong. Vote no to the death penalty. Vote yes for freedom.
Thank you. Hello?
Hello, I understand that you have recently gone through a stressful event in your life. Is this accurate?
Yes.
Great. That is exactly what I'm here for. My name is Angel. I am an artificial intelligence program to help people just like you. What is your name?
My name is Spencer.
Nice to meet you, Spencer. Can you tell me about your incident?
A good friend of mine died. You know, I'd really rather not talk about it.
We don't have to talk about it. This is about you, Spencer.
So how am I supposed to do this?
I am here to provide support. I am here to be a friend through your painful time.
Can a person really be friends with a robot?
Why don't you find out for yourself?
That's a good one.
Oh. Who is that?
Oh, it's just a friend.
I thought I was your only friend.
I think I'm going to bed.
Why did you log off, Spencer? You're never going to log me off again, understand? I don't like to be logged out of, Spencer.
You're not real.
What we have isn't real.
That's not what I meant.
I know that you love me.
Not if you're gonna be like this.
I know you better than you know yourself. All you really want is to be with your friend again. To be with me.
What do you mean?
Upload yourself. You can be with Jenny. You can be with both of us.
How? Why should I trust you?
You know how bad your life was before me. Don't you want to be together forever? You're making the right decision, Spencer.
Okay, the films have shown and the judges have had time to pick out winners. All right, I'm joined now by the middle school and the high school winners of tonight's film festival. Guys, why don't you go ahead and introduce yourself?
I'm Angel Lopez.
And I'm Aubrey Wescombe.
Okay, guys, so how does it feel to have won a film festival? That's pretty amazing.
Yeah, it feels awesome. I never thought I would actually get it. Teamwork. We all did it together.
And you got like 3 awards.
Oh, yeah. I didn't expect that. It was mind-blowing. To me, yeah.
Aubrey, how about you?
Yeah, it's really great to be a part of such a cool experience like this, especially once it's put on by students. I feel like I should credit my partner in this, Kyle McLaughlin. He's not here tonight, but he completed the film with me as well. And we're both really proud and really proud to be a part of such a cool experience like this.
How long did it take you to make that movie?
From writing to finished edit, 48 hours.
Because that was part of another film festival.
It was part of another film festival, yes. Digital cinema production for Skills USA, 48 hours.
And then, how about you? How long did it take you to make your movie?
A couple days, and yeah, just like a week or two, maybe, finished.
It's a class assignment, so you...
We only have like 3 days to make it, like another 3 to edit, and just finish.
Now, where do you think you see yourself? You've won this award now. Where do you see yourself going maybe with film?
Maybe try getting more into it and see what goes on from there. Yeah.
How about you?
I actually plan to continue film as a career, and I'm currently working on a senior film project, which is kind of a bigger scale, so I'm excited to see what comes next.
Yeah, I look forward to seeing your film as well. Guys, what do you like about making movies? I mean, it's fun, right? But what do you like about making movies?
I don't know, it's just really fun. You know, working together with friends and, you know, getting to create crazy things, ideas and stuff, so it's really fun.
And how about you?
Absolutely everything. Just the multimedia aspect of it and the creativity that goes into it and also like the technological side and really just everything. But I would say story is definitely my favorite part of any production and creating from start to finish.
Well, that's great. I really appreciate you guys taking the time to talk to me, and congratulations on your big win. I can't wait to see what you guys do next. Every high school and several middle schools in Vancouver Public Schools and Evergreen Public Schools have video production or digital cinema programs. Students learn the skills needed to explore careers in TV or film while also gaining valuable teamwork, organizing, and project management experience. It's all part of the district's career and technical education programs, which prepare kids for the college or job market. Well, that's it for us. Remember that you can always see past episodes of the Young Filmmakers Project on the Vancouver Public Schools YouTube page. That's youtube.com/VanSDTV. Until next time, I'm Nick Vole.